Or weather. You ever had one of those days where you just want to break things? Well, today's your day. Dan from Imagination Station is here. Good morning, Dan. And
good morning.
Just that, right?
Exactly. You know, I brought some cold ones in for us today, Ryan.
Wow, so that was very generous of you.
I've got one for you here.
Okay.
And I have one for myself. Now, you might want to hold this right here because you've ever seen a trick kind of that people do at parties sometimes? They might.
Oh, yes. They tap the top.
Tap the top.
Oh.
Okay, causes that big foamy mess.
That was just rude.
Okay, that happens.
I thought you were being nice.
But there's some really cool science that's happening before that, and we could even actually do it again.
Can you do it again?
Yep, you can
do it
again.
I didn't know you could do it again. It gets foamier and foamier, right?
It gets foamier and foamier.
Okay.
And I've got another one, so I'll give it a try here. I've got a towel for you.
Look at this guy. Oh, that's
okay.
Very nice.
So I'm going to actually do a hammer, and I'm going to try and hold it up so you can see.
Okay, so you want me to hold this?
No, you can put that. You can throw that away now. You can see there's lots of bubbles of carbon dioxide in there.
Yeah, the carbonation, right?
Yep, carbonation. It's rising up, so hopefully, yeah, that's perfect. We can get a shot of this happening here. I can tap the top.
Whoa!
Okay, and you saw that amazing cascade of bubbles that comes out, right? And what's happening is when you tap the top, okay, it sends a shock wave through the liquid, all right, and it agitates all the teeny tiny carbon dioxide bubbles. Let's put a glove on for this.
Okay, putting a glove on.
It could break the bottle here, and I want to make sure we're staying safe.
Then I'll
put my
safety glasses on.
You should probably put your safety glasses on as well. So you may have seen this trick. I'll go ahead and just demonstrate it.
Okay. Oh, it just breaks the bottom of it off.
Just breaks the bottom right out, okay? And people will do this with their hands. It's kind of painful, and I don't want to cut my hands with the broken glass.
Understandable.
Okay, but what happens is that shock, all right, jolts the bottle down.
Right.
And the water, since it has inertia, all right, wants to stay in the same spot, so the bottle goes down, but the water stays there, and there's a vacuum that's created in the bottom.
Really?
It's pretty amazing. And that vacuum closes shut 10 times faster than it was formed and breaks the bottle.
So I imagine this is happening faster than our naked eye can really
faster
see, because I didn't
can
see
really
it at all.
See. But I believe I have a high-speed footage.
Okay, let's see this. Let's 6, see this video.
6,000 frames per second. If you look on the right-hand side, you can see that little vacuum forming. It slaps shut and breaks the bottle.
It's like an explosion when you look at it like that.
Yeah, it's really amazing, and it comes back so fast.
Okay,
boom,
here it is.
That cavitation bubble has formed, slams back down 10 times faster than it was formed, and bam, knocks the bottom out.
I wouldn't have thought that water.
Now, if you look on
so
the left-hand side, okay, that is a carbonated beverage there, okay, just like we showed you earlier.
We're just looking at.
And you can see that cascading effect, so you can see the oscillation of the bubbles that burst, and then eventually they start to rise up and create more bubbles. They look like little tiny mushroom clouds. It's amazing.
It's almost like a little, like, it's a reaction that just extends all across
the
entire
bottle. It's like a chain reaction that goes whoosh, all the way up. So I brought a glove for you, Ryan.
Okay.
I figured you might want to try and break some bottles.
Well, if we're breaking stuff, I don't want to be left out of the party.
So, go ahead and grab bottle. Okay. That one has the water, just like before, and I'll let you do it.
Right? Okay, hold it about right here?
Yep, you can hold it above there, and give it a nice firm light. You don't want to hit it too hard, but go ahead. Yep, good. Do one more time.
Okay, here we go. Ready?
Perfect.
Ta-da!
Okay, so that first time, did you notice that like metallic clanking sound?
Yeah.
So you actually created a cavitation bubble, but it just wasn't big enough to break the bottle.
I'm not strong enough.
Should we do another one?
I think we should.
I've got another one there for you.
It's cute that you had to ask.
I got one more, too.
Okay, ready?
All right, ready?
Can I do it again?
3, 2, 1. One more time. There it is, right at the bottom.
I need two of them.
You create that cavitation bubble, and that's why you're wearing gloves, so we don't cut ourselves.
Yeah, there's a lot of glass there.
But there's some really cool science happening there, and it's just, you know, some party tricks. You don't really want to do them at home, but.
Yeah, not really. But at least, you know, it teaches us a little bit of science, and it's fun. All at the same time. What do you got going on at Imagination Station?
Well, our summer camps are coming up this summer. You can register on our website. They're open up and ready to go. So if you go to our website, imaginationstationtoledo.org, you can register there.
Is that something that lasts for a couple of weeks? Is that a day camp? What is
that? We actually have like 9 weeks of summer camp all summer long. So you can come
in
and check
it out. Think of all the geekery involved with that.
Oh, yeah.
Can I sign up?
Sure.
All right. I like that. Thank you very much. Doing some party tricks, and I get to feel like Donkey Kong today. Dan, thank you very much.
No problem.
All right. There's more WTOL 11 Your Day in just a moment. We'll be right back.